The average human brain starts shrinking after you turn 40, and this can have a major impact on memory and focus.
In his new book, The Age-Proof Brain, New Strategies to Improve Memory, Protect Immunity, and Fight Off Dementia, scientist and popular speaker Dr. Marc Milstein shares the little things you can do each day to improve your brain health. And Dr. Milstein joins us live. Thanks for being with
us. Good morning.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. Happy to be here.
Boy, it's a little shocking when you say the brain shrinks 5% per decade after the age of 40.
Yeah, it's something we want to be aware of, but the good, hopeful news is that there are things we can do to slow down this process.
And yep. It's not just something like doing crossword puzzles, is it?
No. So if you like doing crossword puzzles, that's a good thing to do, but it's not the only thing. And we want to let people be aware that there's a lot of other things they can do, too.
So the first one is sleep. What about sleep? How much?
Well, in general, the recommendation is about 7 to 9 hours a night. And the reason why sleep is so important is for many reasons, but one is that when you're sleeping at night, you're actually removing waste, trash, and toxins from your brain, and that can impede brain function. It can cause the brain to shrink. So every night when you go to sleep, you actually squeeze out waste from your brain and keep it clean. You give your brain a brain wash. So we really want to be prioritizing and optimizing sleep.
I don't think I know a single adult who can sleep 7 to 9 hours a night.
Yeah, what about the nap? Does it have to, can it add up to 7 hours?
Naps count. So naps count for the 7 to 9. Some people can do fine with less than 7, but it's a small percentage of the population. So if you're not getting enough, we just want to, you know, get the word out that it's important to make it a priority.
All right. What about food? I'm assuming it's, you know, no processed food, all that kind of stuff. Anything unique there that we haven't heard before?
Well, some things to think about are that just looking at your plate, most meals and having a colorful array of fruits and vegetables, like you said, staying away from the processed foods. You know, I was in the museum in Chicago there that I love so much, and they have that Twinkie that was unwrapped that still looks like you could eat it and it would be delicious. Those ultra processed foods that never spoil. We want to stay away from all the additives and preservatives. And one thing to be aware of is that, you know, some of the foods like the broccoli and the spinach, the way you prepare them can make a difference too. So we don't want to overcook them because that can deplete some of those key nutrients that are so good for the brain.
All right, so we've heard some of this stuff before, including exercise, but can you quantify something tangible for, let's say, the reduction of dementia as it relates to walking or exercising?
Yeah, so getting about 30 minutes of walking a day can lower the risk of dementia or memory loss by about 60%.
Wow.
And so that's
just
walking. It doesn't have to all be done at the same time. And that's really what this is all about, is how do we lower risk with simple little things that we can do. So walking, you know, to the store, walking around your house, it all counts. And it's really important for memory and can lower the risk of dementia.
You also say repeating information back, like once you hear it, when someone tells you their name, just repeating it back out loud, saying that helps?
Yeah, absolutely. So our brain wants to play with information to remember it. So if you meet somebody and you want to remember their name, you don't want it to just disappear into thin air, saying it back, repeating it out loud. Even just imagine writing their name on their forehead after they tell you their name. That extra few seconds of focusing on their name can help you remember somebody's name. So it's easy to forget in today's world. You know, we're always multitasking, we're so busy. So these extra few seconds of saying things out loud, you know, repeating, writing things down can really help our brain focus and hold on to information.
All right. Thank you, doctor. For more, check out drmarkmilstein.com or you can follow him on social media. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Time now for Around Town.